Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. One of my honorable friends said, in the course of the debate today, that many of these schemes are developed in a haphazard manner. I join issue there. We have heard a lot about the need for greater coordination. I am aware that there is room for greater coordination not only amongst the different ministries but also between the center and the states, and if I may say so, between the government and the members of this house, and if I may add a little further, between the government and the people of this country. In fact, I feel more and more today that there is considerable cleavage between the government and the people because of lack of information on the part of the people of the steps which government has taken in the course of the last 2 years, in spite of tremendous odds and difficulties. Here, if I may say in all humility, is a responsibility which members of this house, particularly those belonging to the Great Congress Organization, have to take upon themselves. You have to go to the people and have got to inspire them to the needs of the situation and to explain to them what government has done, so that you may get the largest possible response from the pupil. That gap has come into existence. Let us not throw buckets at each other and say that government should do it and you should not. But the fact remains that the gap is there, and the question is how that gap can be filled up and pupils' enthusiasm can be fully roused. So far as government's scheme are concerned, I might very briefly allude to one or two schemes so that the House will be able to realize how their non-implementation may adversely affect the economic conditions of the country. The House is aware that we have entered into a contract with a well-known Swiss firm for the manufacture of machine tools it is a big scheme which will cost India nearly rupees 150 to 280 crores. We are importing today about rupees 80 crores worth machine tools. The Prime Minister pointed out yesterday, and quite rightly, that this is one of the basic industries which must develop in this country if we are going to progress industrially. How far that scheme will be affected now is more than what I can say, because we have to settle the question of priorities and decide which are the schemes with which we will go ahead. The same principle applies with regard to the production of steel. After considerable efforts, we have completed our levers, full stop.